Welcome back to LoyalTV. Right here in the center of Oklahoma is a quaint little town named El Reno. A city formed after the 1889 land rush and named after a fort located just a few miles away. Every year, the people of El Reno bring the past to life to honor the legacy of each soldier and civilian who passed through the revered gates of Fort Reno. This is the rich history they celebrate. Come back to 1874, where buffalo and cavalry soldiers, Indian scouts, so many souls were settling into what was initially a temporary camp. This fort was established to enforce and protect the Darlington Agency, which had been established on the Cheyenne and Arapaho Indian reservations a few years earlier. The base took its name from General Jesse L. Reno, who was killed at South Mountain, Maryland during the Civil War. Located just 2 miles north of present-day El Reno in Canadian County, Oklahoma, the camp's numbers and responsibilities grew rapidly, and it was officially inaugurated as Fort Reno on July 15, 1875. Throughout the 1880s, the fort's 9th Cavalry Buffalo Soldiers and Indian Scouts played a key role in tracking and arresting trespassers in the region. Troops of the 5th Cavalry also signaled the start and monitored the opening of the land run. However, by the end of the 19th century, the need for Fort Reno to keep the peace on the Indian frontier had lessened to the point that nearly all of Fort Reno's cavalry and infantry forces went to serve in the Spanish-American War. The post finally shut down as an active military base in 1908. However, that same year, the Army reactivated Fort Reno, using the grounds as a remount station, where troopers trained cavalry horses and mules. Soon, surrounding pastures were overflowing with four-legged soldiers preparing for duty in both World Wars and eventually Korea. At the time, Fort Reno also offered a one-of-a-kind polo competition. In fact, during September of 1929, polo enthusiast Will Rogers even traveled to Fort Reno to attend a match. In 1948, Fort Reno was assigned to the U.S. Department of Agriculture, which, in coordination with what would become Oklahoma State University, established a livestock and forage research center. And by 1970, the National Park Service had recognized the fort's historic significance and listed it in the National Register of Historic Places. Today, the annual Tombstone Tales at Fort Reno Festival transports visitors back to its vivid glory days. Held at the Fort Reno Post Cemetery at dusk, more than a dozen actors recreate stories of those who lived and died at the old fort, all dressed in actual attire of the era. And for a moment, you truly envision the old outlaws, the soldiers and scouts, the stagecoach drivers, all the men, women, and children who ride once again at Fort Reno. Join us on the next episode of LoyalTV, where we continue to share the best Oklahoma stories you've never heard.